Hey, welcome to Islebound Games. I'm Anthony.
And I'm Frances.
Today we're going to play
Islebound. Islebound's by Red Raven Games and takes about 60 to 120, 120 minutes to play. Two to four.
Mm-hmm. It is a exploration, worker placement, resource.
Kind of has a little bit of everything.
So yeah. Resource management, building an empire almost. So, we'll take you to the table, show you how to play, and let's get started.
Okay, welcome to the table.
On the other side of the board.
So we flipped our table, and now we're playing on the dark side. So what you see is basically the setup for a game of Islebound. This is the playboard, essentially, and this is going to be where all of the islands and cities and towns and different actions we're going to be able to take as we travel around the board. This is modular, so it's randomly, each tile is randomly selected and put up. All the corners are, as well as the centers. The center boards have two sides. The other side is easy. This side is hard or difficult, and we're playing on the difficult setting. It really doesn't make it all that difficult. Just probably makes it for a little bit longer game.
But it makes it a little bit more expensive to do things.
So it takes you a little while to get longer. But at the end of the day, with the two players, this isn't that long of a game anyway. Mm-hmm. All right, so we have our player boards here, which are basically our ships, and these are our player tokens, I guess you could call them.
So which are our ships.
I'm yellow, this is my boat, Francis is green, right? Mm-hmm. We've chosen our starting ports. I've chosen Thundrake down mm-hmm. here.
And I chose Krimsika.
Krimsika, which is up in the left corner. We've placed one of our player tokens there to identify that's where our starting port is. That'll make sense what that means later on. But so just quick overview of the components of what we have set up here. So we each have our boats. We each have $7. Up here on our player board, you have your speed rating, and all the boats start at speed rating of 2. There's ways to increase that. Down here is your cargo hold, where you can hold up to 10 fish and or wood, depending, but 10 max. If you ever have to take more, you can dump whatever you want, but that's where you store that. Up here we'll store our books when we get them. There's no limit to how many books you can have. And above deck is where we have our active crew, and as we use them for certain actions, they will go to sleep down in the hammocks, and they can't be used until we go to a port that has a bed. We've got 3 starting crew, 2 diplomats or administrators, mm-hmm. and 1 deckhand, right? And then you'll see that those symbols come into play as we start to take actions. Over here we have the renown board, where up top you'll see there's a renown track and renown tokens. We have event cards, we have reputation cards, we have the crew offer, where we can hire a new crew. We have our treasure map, where we can go treasure hunting. And down here we have our influence track, where we will be able to accrue interest to spend when allying towns. The first 2 squares on that track are blocked with red tokens. For a 2-player game, you block those 2 off. We have our resource pool, so there's wood, there's fish, there's books, and there's money. We have our attack dice. Down here we have the building offer. With these book tokens above them, the book tokens indicate how many books you have to have in your possession in order to make a purchase from that particular column, if mm-hmm. you will. So like these 2, you don't need any books, you would need 1, 2, or 3. The cards for buildings, just to go over that really quick, each card has a couple of different things on it, right? So it's got the type of building it is, what the cost and cost and renown
value
mm-hmm. will be at the end of the game. So this would cost me 5 gold if I were to buy it, and would be worth 5 points at the end of the game. And we found that the scoring in this game, the renown to token or mm-hmm. to coin ratio is 1-to-1. So, and this is, if you were to actually build this building, so there's 2 ways you can acquire a building. You can build it if you go to Stratic, where it has that build symbol. It's the only place you can actually build buildings from. You can build 1 building there, and that building will cost you resources. So it'll cost you 2 wood and 2 fish. So if you don't want to spend 5 gold, you spend the resources to build it in Stratic. We'll go over player actions in a second. So I think, did I miss anything?
No, we'll go over everything as we play.
Okay, so you are going to be player 1, and basically the way this game goes is you have certain actions you can take. Actions, mm-hmm. some actions are limited, some are free. Mm-hmm. The very first thing you do, no matter what on your turn, is move. You cannot start and take an action in the space you are in when you start your turn. So the first thing you do is move. Once you move up to your speed, so you don't have to move the full distance of your speed. So in this case, we would be able to move one or two spaces. And every space is indicated by basically where an island is. Every one space is gets you to the next island, right? And every island is unique and every island has different actions. When you land on a certain island, you want to take the action. You have a couple of choices. You can take free actions, or you could visit the port and take a port action, but you can only take, you know, the port action once in some cases, multiple times in others, depending on what that port action is. So that's simple enough. If we want to take real quick on the board, if you, these event cards are in certain specific locations. If you're on that location, you can attempt to solve that event if, you know, for a free action. You can do that in addition to visiting port. To identify where on the map those two events are, those brown tokens, we'll move them every time we complete one. So I think that's quick, down and dirty. Over here we have pirates, serpents, and Ichon or Ikor?
Ikor.
Is it Ikor?
It's Ikor.
It looks like an N.
It's a Celtic kind of font.
All right.
You
so,
know how I am about my fonts.
Right, he's a special serpent that one of the buildings could get you, enable you to acquire him. So
let's cross that bridge when we get there.
We may or may not get to it. So, the objects, you're probably wondering what the object of the game is. Quite simply, this game could go on forever if you do not go for
buildings.
Buildings. Buildings are the timer. Yeah. They are the timer. If you do not buy buildings in this game, the game will never end. So basically, when you play the game, play to buy buildings. Buildings are how you gain renown points. Buildings are how you stop the game and how you end the game and where you'll get most of your points. So do not spend your time. I know, as much fun as it is to go trouncing around the archipelago and visit...
I'm sorry, what was that?
Is it archipelago?
Archipelago.
Archipelago. And visit all these happy places and do all these great things and gather resources and buy stuff. Buy the buildings.
Yeah, we need to buy eight to end
eight.
The game.
Eight buildings.
A single player.
Single player.
So.
A single player has to buy eight.
A single player has to buy eight.
And then we take one full turn each.
Exactly.
After that.
We'll get to that when we pass it.
Whatever.
So, all right. I'm antsy. Can we start?
I know. Okay. Okay. So we'll get ready to go off the first turn.
All right.
Let's move forward.
Move forward. All right. I'll move my ship forward. All right. So so my ship, like Anthony said, starts with a speed of two, which means I can move one, two islands. But I'm only going to move one. I'm going to go here. Boom. I don't like that the ship is not multi-directional.
Yes.
Okay. It bothers me. All right. So
I'm talk about that later.
Well, okay. Well, I'm moving to Rock Slide. So each island has a specific action associated with it, which is kind of like a benefit if you visit it. So the first thing I'm going to do is move here, and I'm going to decide I'm visiting the town. It's one of three actions that I, one of four actions actually, that I can take when I land on a space. So you can visit a town, you can try to take it over, either with an attack or with diplomacy, which we'll, I'm sure, see later on. Or you can actually treasure hunt, so we can hunt for some treasure. And so we'll see that. But there's nothing in the treasure pot, and I don't feel like taking anything over, so I'm going to visit. It costs me whatever's on this brown flag to visit the town. So I'm docking my ship, and I'm going to stay there. So here on Rockslide, I have to pay one coin. And this little administrative symbol with the arrow under it means I have to exhaust one of my administrators. So I guess they're talking shop or something like that. So they're actually going to go right underneath of the board. We like to put them sideways because there's these little hammocks on there. So they have to sleep. So I'm going to exhaust my worker. I'm going to pay this to the treasure map. So it does not go to the bank. It goes to kind of this collective pot because nobody owns this town yet. But I've paid my dues and now I get to take my action. So here I get to pay two coins for every worker that I have, and I will get one book and two renown.
Correct.
So
every
active worker, and I have two active workers currently.
Right.
And I'm going to pay four. So
pay for what?
For you to stop telling those jokes.
Oh, sorry.
All right. So here's your... Wait, I'm paying that to the bank. So yes. I'm paying four to the bank.
Mm-hmm. You could
there's
pay
my
me.
One.
It's fine.
Nah, it's okay. And I'm going to get two books. This is a great place to store your books.
Yes. So says the book.
So says the book.
So
and then I'm going to go up on the renown track 4 points.
One, two, three, four.
Now, the renown track up at the top, this is how we're getting our points. This is basically our victory point track. So everything we do in the game, well, a lot of things in the game are going to award us our victory points. So I just went 4. Now, I have the option of taking some free actions. Mm-hmm. I could build a building if I wanted to pay the cost for the building.
Right, that's a free action.
That's a free action I could do. I don't have that much money left, so I'm probably not going to do that.
No, you don't.
So I think I'm pretty much done, I think.
Okay, that's it. So that's the end of your turn.
So that's the end of my turn, and I declare it's the end of my turn.
Right,
so.
Now, being that you're on Rockside, you could have also performed the event.
I could have, but see, the thing is, with this event in Rockside, it has this red flag. Anywhere you see a red flag means you have the opportunity to try to
attack.
So the event cards are kind of like, the text will be something about, you know, attacking mm-hmm. something or some kind of confrontation. But in order to attack, you need to have people to attack with.
Right.
And that's going to be your pirates and your serpents. Or your crew.
But you could technically.
I could technically, but I don't really want to.
Okay. If you use your crew to attack, it's very strenuous on them. So they'll not only become exhausted, but they will flip face down as almost as if they're injured.
Right. And then you have to rest them twice
to bring them back. Yeah. Once here and then once back on deck. So that's
it's
a pretty big sacrifice at this stage, unless you have a lot of crew, I guess.
Yeah. For the most part, we're probably going to use our pirates and stuff, but you can only acquire them somewhere else on the map, and I haven't gotten any yet. So.
That is true.
All right. So your turn.
So my turn. So basically, we're just going to keep alternating back and forth and taking these actions. So I think I will start off by going to the one, two. Do I want to go there? Or do I want to go there?
Decisions.
Do I want to go there? Okay. Okay. I think. All right, so I'm going to go 1, 2, and I'm going to stop in Moreland. So Moreland's going to, and I'm going to visit the town. It's going to cost me to exhaust any worker, so I'll exhaust an administrator, and pay a gold to the treasure map. So I paid the cost. Now I get to perform this action. So I get to buy one of these, and I'll buy him. Now this guy's got the dollar symbol, so he's going to cost me $1, which I pay to the bank. These guys slide over, and I refresh. Oops. And then I can also get 1 wood per hand. Mr. Hand. So I have 2 active hands, deck hands, so I'm going to get 2 wood from the supply.
Okay.
So 2 pieces of wood, and I will store them in my storage facility.
Mm-hmm.
And that ends my turn if I wanted it to end, and I do.
Okay.
So you get to go now.
You're a mess. Okay. all right. I'm going to travel. I'm going to travel up to the grotto.
The grotto.
So I'm going to pay $1 to the treasure map.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to get 3 fish plus 1 fish per hand I have. So I have 1 hand right now. So I'm going to get 4 fish. What?
You've got 2.
I do.
Yeah.
Unlike Jamie Lannister.
That's true.
Okay, so I'm going to put the fish right in my, under my deck, I guess, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and then I get 1 renown for visiting the grotto. So you bought me up 1. Perfect.
Hoarding renown this game.
I know. And I can't quite do anything else, so. Yeah.
Okay, so what to do? I think what I will do. That's interesting. I could do that, or I could do that. But I think what I will do. You see, that's really not good for me. I'll just go. I'm gonna go. Bing. I'm gonna go to Rat Nest. So Rat Nest is gonna cost me $1. So if you give me change, please. And I have to exhaust an administrator because Rat Nest is a pirate town. So my diplomat is gonna be busy. So this goes in the treasure map. Yeah, $4. So money is scarce in this game, as you can see, mm-hmm. early on at least. It gets yeah. pretty good. So I'm going to get two pirates.
All the pirate cards are the same.
Yep. So. And all the serpents are the same.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get to rest. So my two guys that are my two administrators that were resting are now back in business. So I've got $4 and I don't think I want to take any more free actions. So your turn.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna go to 1, 2. I'm gonna stop at Farwald. And I get.
Oh, you're okay. gonna visit?
Yeah. Here you go.
Mm-hmm.
I need 2 fish.
So you get 1 wood or 2 fish.
Uh-huh. And I also get this trumpet.
So you get to toot your own horn.
I get to toot my own horn. Farwald is kind of like, I guess, the main village. So you get to, like, brag about your ship.
I've done so much at this point.
I've been fishing. All right. So, and our options are over here. And the game gives you 2, like, different little decks to use. Right. So brag of your supplies.
All right.
Except I have no wood.
Right.
Brag of your control. Perceive board where you control more towns than any other planet at all. So, I guess I have literally nothing to brag about right now.
That is correct. So, yeah. You don't... Because these are... The 4 main boards are the seaboards.
Yeah.
These are the ports. So you're not going to...
Yeah.
You're not going to toot your own horn. Because it really wouldn't be worth it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's right, though. So that's all.
Very good. So, I'm going to go and I'm going to visit Rock Slide. All right. So, I'm going to pay $1. And I'm going to... Actually, do I want to do that? I'm not going to do that. I'm going to actually hunt for treasure here. So I'm not going to visit the port. I'm going to hunt for treasure.
Take that.
You take what? Take what? Take. I'm taking that. Take all of that. I'm going to hunt for treasure. So I don't get to visit the port. So I had to pass that up. But what I am going to do now is I'm going to do the event. So I will select this because... I'm on that location. So, Rockslide, a dream prowler gets free from his cage at the docks. Sounds of screaming fill the air as travelers, sailors, and villagers flee in every direction. Now, this has that red flag with a 1 value, which means I need to do 1 attack to it. So, I can assign as many of my troops, my soldiers, or my serpents to this. And for every one of them, I get to roll 1 combat die. And depending on what I roll, if I roll a 1... I get 1 damage. If I roll a 4 or better, I get 2 damage. So I roll the die. I roll a 6. That's 2 damage. I didn't even need to roll technically because all I needed was 1 to defeat this. So once you use a pirate or a serpent in combat, they're expended and they're gone. So I defeated Rockslide and I get 1 influence on the influence track. So the way you fill the influence track is you put 1 of your tokens, 1 of your markers on the furthest left available space. So now I've got 1 influence. And influence can be spent to ally with any of the blue flag towns on the map. So this is done and out of the game, and my turn is over.
I'm going to Fell's Garden, and I'm not treasure hunting because there's no treasure.
Oh.
So it's your turn again.
How did that happen? So you're not going to do anything there. All right. So hold on. We have to move that brown marker from Rockslide to Zillium.
Right, there we go.
Right, so that's where the next event is. And that one is just pay 2 fish to complete. Oh, if only I had fish. So, I'm going to go to... I'm going to go 1. Do I want to do that? No, I'm going to go to Undervol. 1, 2, and I'm going to visit, so I'll pay. I get 1 renown and 1 troop, so I finally get some renown, and I can take a deckhand. And I will take, for 1 gold, this fish guy. Now, the fish guy, while he's active and on deck, I get, because he has that little wave symbol, I get 1 extra speed, so he's going to help me travel now, so I get to move up to 3 speed. He gets refreshed. And I can take the Undervol event as my free action. And This one says, a local blacksmith contacts you. I have some extremely precious star metal that needs to be transported to Thrym. Help me, and I won't forget it. So I have to give him help with one of my deckhands. So that's really just that. I'll use one of my deckhands to help him, and I will get one more influence. So I get to go in the furthest left track. And that ends my turn. And this goes to... Well, it stays in Zillium. No, it goes to the grotto. I'm sorry. The grotto.
Okay. It doesn't really matter. Your turn.
You're not going to hire... Oh, you can't visit. Wow. You're not going to treasure hunt and at least take one coin?
I will.
Yeah, you might as well, right?
Yeah, thanks. That works, actually.
All right. Well, that allows you to stop anywhere now.
I'm a little mad that you took all the treasure.
I'm not allowed to.
You're not even spending it.
I needed the money. I'm not spending it yet. I've got plans. I've got big plans. can you move me down to Zillium, please? I can't pay the fish, but you know what?
You can pay wood.
I can, so I will... Well, I mean, I wanted to do the Zillium thing. I don't have any fish. So I'm visiting Zillium, so I paid. I'm going to now pay a wood... and exhaust a crew member. So fish or wood, exhaust a crew member and get a book. So here's a wood. I think I might as well do that twice. Two fish, two crew, and I'll take two books, please. Thank you. And that's a nice place to put my books. I'm done, you can go.
You sure?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Good. So you took my building. I was going to be really upset. Boards were going to go flying. I'm in Stratic, and I'm going to build something. So here's my... I'm going to pay that to the treasure map.
Why didn't I buy it?
I don't know. Put it in the treasure map. It turns over.
Because I wanted that one.
And I'm going to exhaust my worker.
You've just ruined my whole strategy.
And I'm going to pay all six of my... Five. I get to keep a fish, so I'll pay five fish. Back to the ocean, I suppose.
Oh, because you saw me buy the two books. Would you have been that mad?
Yes.
I should have bought that.
So I'll show you what this is. So this is a building, and this particular building, it's worth 6 points at the end of the game, but it gives me two renown when I ally with a town. And I have a tendency to ally, not fight, so I knew that that was one that I was going to want. So I picked
so
that out
early.
All right, and I will not take any free actions, so you're up.
That's just terrible.
And then Anthony just refreshed the deck, so you'll see that everything slides down and we just flip another one. So.
Oh, I'm so disappointed right now. So... I really let that one slip through my fingers.
Maybe if you weren't so greedy.
Oh, I'm just disgusted right now. So disgusted. All right, so let me go to... Would you mind sending me to Rat's Nest, please? I'm going to take two pirates. It's right above. Just north.
Oh, here.
Yep, okay. So I'll pay $1. I will exhaust... A administrator.
Okay.
I will take two more pirates.
There you go.
And I will rest all of my crew.
Okay.
And I think, like, for my free action, I could buy a house right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to.
Okay.
I'm not going to buy a house yet.
No.
Pirates here. You can go.
Okay. All right. I will go to...
What? Tables will be flying.
Oh, man. You're so funny. I only have one fish, so I can't really do that. Well, here's what I'll do. I'm going to go here to Rock Slide.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to treasure hunt.
Okay.
Because I got some new money. And I'm not going to do anything else, so you're up.
Okay. I'm going to travel 1, 2,
mm-hmm.
to the grotto. And I'm going to get three fish plus one for every deckhand. So I've got three deckhands. So I'm going to get six fish.
Okay.
If you will. And I get one renown. I'm going to pay a gold to visit.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There you go.
Thank you. So I've got almost a full hold here. And now I'm in the grotto. I can attack this two event, and I think I will. So the grotto event is, you watch as pirates descend upon a nearby ship. Do you stop to defend the victims? I certainly do. I'm just going to spend two of my pirates, so I just have to roll a one and a five. So
there you go.
I scored three, so I overkilled it, but you never can be sure in this game. So I get two influence tokens, so I will put two more on the influence track. Now, the influence track is a little different than the norm, but what you do is basically for every cube you have, every one of your cubes you have here, you get the underneath amount. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So right now I have 7 influence, and that could be used to take over a town that has up to 7 influence. That's blue. So I could take these over and spend the cubes. And you spend them by selecting whatever cubes you want off the track. It doesn't have to be in any sequential order. So
you just add them up.
You just add them up. As long as you come up to the amount of points you need, you'll take over the town. But we'll see that when it happens. So we got to move that to Sun's Rest.
Nice. Okay.
So that's where the next mission is. I have 4 gold, which is not enough for me to do anything that I want to do. So you can go.
Okay. All right. Fantastic. Let's move forward. I'm going to. I still only have one fish. I'm going to go to my home port of Krymska, and I'm going to rest my people. So when we visit towns that we either own or like our home ports we own off the bat, we don't have to pay.
So you just ignore whatever's in this brown flag.
So I'm going to go ahead and put those guys up. And I think I actually might go ahead and pay a book
to
and gain a renown.
Gain renown, so you're up to 6.
No, not to gain a renown. Sorry, to gain influence.
Oh, okay.
So I'm gonna put one of my little chips right there.
I don't know why I put these here.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Okay, and I'm good, I think.
You are.
Yeah, I'm good. Yep.
All right, so I'm going to go 1, 2 to Sun's Rest. I'm first going to pay. Do I want to do this?
I don't know. That's all your influence.
Yeah, but all your influence belong to us. 2, 4, 6, 7. So I'm going to pay 7 influence. That's all my influence. And I'm going to take over Sun's Rest through
diplomacy.
So I've used my influence to take ownership of this town. I will put a cube there, and I will collect coins in the amount of the strength of that town. So that town is worth 7 coins to me. So I just made $7. And now I can visit the town for free after you take it over.
Yep.
So I am going to spend 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of my fish.
Okay.
Actually, no.
Really? You can't.
What?
3. Oh, you're going to do it 3 times?
I could do it 3 times.
You could do. Yeah.
You can do.
You can do.
You can do. So I'm going to take... Actually, I'm going to spend 4 of my fish.
Okay.
And I am going to do this twice. I will exhaust 2 workers, so I will do 1...
And again, that's indicated right on the board.
Any worker. Doesn't matter. And I will gain a serpent for each time, so I get 2 serpents.
2 serpents.
And 2 renown for that little flag. So I will go 1, 2. And for my free action, I'm going to spend 5, 6, 7, 8 of my hard-earned money. And I'm going to buy the Academy of Builders. So this is when you gain a building, I get plus 1 renown. So that will be there. So now for every subsequent building I purchase or build, I will gain an extra renown point.
Nice.
I am done.
You're done.
I'm so done.
Okay. All right. Great. Okay, I think I'm going to visit. I think I need some. Oh, sorry, what?
Never mind.
Did you want to keep going?
Yeah.
What would you like to do?
Okay.
No,
what I was going like to do the event.
Go ahead.
Because I can take as many reactions as I
Go ahead.
I'll exhaust these two because Sun's Rest requires two. And in Sun's Rest, the mayor of a neighboring island sent you a letter. We are having trouble ironing out a treaty with our old rivals. Can you act as our mediator? So I will be their mediator with my two guys, and
okay.
I will gain two influence for that.
Okay.
Because I did such a good job, and that moves to Fellsgarden.
Okay. Are you satisfied?
I am now satisfied.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna go over there. All right. I think I'm gonna go to Rock Slide again.
You'd love that place.
I do. I'm gonna pay two.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. And
are you paying me?
Oh, yeah.
Well, first you gotta pay one.
Yeah.
And exhaust an administrator.
Sorry, there you go. Exhaust that guy. And I'm gonna pay two to the bank.
Okay.
And I'm gonna get my book back. I'm gonna get two renown.
Alright, one, two. You've reached seven. So this comes off the board and she claims the token.
And I also get the reward that's on the token. That's a one time. So I'm going to get three coins as well.
And that's how you keep track of how many renown you've earned. So for every seven, you get a marker to indicate the seven, plus a little bonus of whatever items are on it.
Yeah. So
all right.
That's it.
So you're done?
Yeah, I'm good.
You're good. All right. I guess. I guess I will go to the Rat's Nest, maybe? No. Yeah, Rat's Nest. I'll go there.
Final answer?
Yep, final answer. We'll pay one coin. Oh, I don't have an administrator. I can't go there. Never mind. So I need an administrator to rest there.
Mm-hmm.
That's no bueno. Ooh, okay. So, one, two, three, four. Let me see. I think, God, that's terrible. That's so terrible. I guess send me to Marhaven then. I need to rest.
Okay.
So I'm going to the port of Marhaven. Pay a coin, I get a pirate, and I get to sleep all of my people. Because they were all so tired. So tired. All right.
Okay. All right, I will go to one, two. I'll go to Moorlim.
Oh,
I think. All right. And
are you gonna visit?
Yeah. Yeah, I will. Here. So there's that.
An exhaust new worker.
I will. Please hold. I'm trying to think who I want to exhaust. So I'm gonna exhaust my administrator. Other administrator.
Mm-hmm.
But I get a person.
You do.
So I will get that curly weird kid on the
end. Freebie?
Yes, the free guy. So
right.
And you'll see that on some of these too, there's this one has a hand, but he also has a little piece of like a die. Which allows me to roll an extra dice like if I'm doing an attack
if
or something.
If you exhaust him, yes.
If I put him to sleep.
Temporarily.
And then I also get a wood per hand I have, and I have two. So,
Mr. Hand.
There we go, Mr. Hand. Perfect. And I won't be doing anything else. So you're up.
Very good. All right, I am going to visit, I think. One, two, three. One, two, three. Where can I go to get done what I need doing? All right, so let me go to Stratic. One, two, three. And I'm going to attack the town of Stratic.
Okay.
I think. No, I don't want to do that.
Aiden Peterson.
I know, I've got AP going on here. So I think I think I'll go to... It really doesn't matter where I go at this point. You know, actually, it kind of does. So I'm going to go to Zillium. Mm-hmm. Or Fell's Garden. Do I want to go to Fell's Garden? Yeah. I'm going to go here. I'm going to treasure hunt.
One, two, three.
Treasure hunt. Take all that fine gold. But now I could do Fell's Garden's quest for glory, the event. So when you arrive at the docks, smoke billows from burning houses and villagers run this way and that. Mad Mask and his band are raiding our town, calls out a sailor as he leaps into the bay, swimming to get away. So I need 4 combat to beat this town. So I'm just going to pay a serpent. I don't really like to gamble, so because the dice are not kind to me. So I'm going to try to do this. I need now the serpents, although they have pretty good strength, their die roll, you don't just get a freebie. You got to roll at least a 3 out of these 3 dice, right? So, and I did. So I rolled a 4, a 6, and a 1. So I got a 1, a 4, and a 6. So it's 3, 4, 5, 6 I actually did. So more than enough. These guys are out of the game. And I completed Fell's Garden, so I actually get 3 influence cubes on the track, which is Mondo. Boom. With my final action, I am going to pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gold. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to purchase the combat arena building, which gives me 3 renown when I use attack to take a town away from another player.
I never take attack down, so.
You know what? Oh, okay. Okay. Well, that's just terrible. Oh, that's an end game score. Wow, that's cool. 13. That's
I think I had that one. Yeah, that's the one I had last game.
Yeah. That's a pretty good
one. That's a good one.
Okay.
All right.
Probably not the best card to buy, but whatever.
That's a good card.
It's all right. Not if you're not taking over any combat towns.
Oh, you've played with this with me how many times?
True, but I could take your home port.
You could. You definitely could.
All right, so.
Okay, so that is a good one, though,
if you do take one over. We have to go Borsham?
Are we going to Borsham? From
Fell's
Garden. Perfect, Borsham. Right there. Right. Awesome. Okay. Okay.
Oh, and I gained a building, so I actually go up one right now. Sorry.
Are you done?
Yes, I'm done.
Okay. I'm going to visit the grotto.
The grotto.
To the treasure map. I'm gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fish.
Wow.
5, 6, 7, 8, so I'm still okay. And if you could put me up 1 renown, please.
You go 1 renown for that visit, huh?
I do. Right. And I'm good. I'm not gonna do anything else.
You're done.
I'm done.
Okay. I think. Ooh. What I think I'll do is then. This is no good. All right, I'm gonna go 1, 2, visit Greenill and gather wood. So I'm gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wood. So 2 plus 1 per hand. So I get 5 wood, please.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five. There you go.
All right, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Your turn.
Okay. I'm gonna go to Farwald again. and I'm gonna get 1 wood. Oh wait, here's my money. Mm-hmm. So pay that to the treasure map, please. So I'll get my wood. So I can pick a wood or 2 fish, but I'm picking 1 wood. And now I can use that.
Toot your own horn?
Toot my own horn. Because I get 1 renown for each log that I own, and I own 3.
Alright.
So, brag of my supplies.
That's not very big bragging.
Hey. I got some wood.
All right.
And I paid, and I guess that is it. So you're up.
So you're done. All right. Let me do this then. 1, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. I'm going to pay 3 wood. Mm-hmm. So I can pay, and I'm going to pay a dollar. Oh, I don't have a dollar. Never mind. How am I broke?
You're broke as a joke, man.
Really? This is so terrible. Where was I? I got wood last time, so I was here. Yeah, then forget it. I'm going to do other things. I've got bigger fish to fry right now. 3. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm doing.
Okay.
I'm going to Rat's Nest, and I'm taking it over.
Okay.
It's 3, 4, 5, mm-hmm. 6, 7.
Perfect. Nice job.
All right. So I get $7 for that.
Okay.
I don't have to pay to be here anymore. And I can visit it. I'll take 2.
Pirates?
Pirates, please. And that will not be the end of my turn because I'm going to buy another building. So I'm going to pay. I'm going to pay. I have $7. Dang, nabbit.
You can buy a nice gambling hall.
I'm going to do that, actually.
Okay.
Here's 5. I'll take 2 back. Take 2 back. And I will take a gambling hall, and I will gain a renown for building another building. Mm-hmm. Well, everybody slides this way.
Okay.
I am done. You
all
may
right.
go.
Okay. Oh, I can actually probably do that. I think I will. Oh, I won't. Wait, I will. I'm going to go 1, 2. I'm going to go to Zillium. Mm-hmm. I'm treasure hunting. So, the treasure, please.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. And I will take the action as well. So I'll pay 2 fish.
Okay, so read it out. See what
and
happens.
And I'm paying those to the ocean. So it says a local tavern owner finds you. Rats have gotten into my food cellar and all the food is contaminated. If I don't get a fresh supply, I'll be out on the street. Okay. So I paid 2 fish to feed his town. So I get 1 influence for that. So the way this works is that we have to fill from the left. So Anthony used some of his cubes, which left holes, and I have to kind of fill in where those holes were.
So you can't just start jumping up to the big numbers.
Yeah,
number, so.
Exactly. That's it.
All right. So I am going to... I'm going to go to Stratic.
Okay.
Boom. And I'm going to attack it.
Mm.
This is going to be a very risque attack.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to get 3 dice. And I've got a 1, a 4, and a 6. So I've got 3, 4, 5, 6. More than enough.
Yep, perfect.
So I defeated Stratic through combat. So that's how combat works.
Mm-hmm.
I lose all my troops. I get 5 gold, or 5 coins for doing that. And now I get to visit Stratic for free. So I don't have to pay the administrative costs, but I can now build a building from here if I pay the resources. And I'm going to buy a construction hut that costs 3 wood and 2 fish.
Nice.
So I built a construction yard. I gain a building, so I go up 1 more renown, which puts me over the edge. So I get 2 books for that.
There you go.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And I slide these down. And for my free action, I think, remember, now I get to pay, so with my construction yard, I pay 1 less gold when I buy a house.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to buy, when you place a cube, okay, I'm going to pay $5 for the town hall. So now I have more than 3 books I can purchase from there. So I bought a town hall that gives me +1 renown when I place a cube on the influence track. And then I gain another renown for building another building. All right, your turn.
Okay. I'm going to go to Thundrake, and I'm going to visit. So put that there for me. And I don't know if I want to pay my book. Yeah, I guess I'll pay my book for 2 renown. So if you could bump me up 2 renown. I'm green.
Oh.
Try and get yourself extra points. See how you work.
I need all I can get.
And I get to rest my workers. And that is all I'm going to do.
Okay.
Did you take that coin?
What coin?
I landed here and you own that town.
I put it right there.
Yeah, but
oh, I didn't take it. Oh.
I mean, you can put it in the treasure map if you want to.
That's right. So she landed on one of my towns, so I actually take the fees as if I landed on her town. Well, you went to my port?
Mm-hmm.
You went to my port?
I did. I'm sleeping all up in there.
Oh, that's no good. That is no good at all. All right, my turn?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what to do. I don't... Alright, I'm gonna go. Borsham, huh? Is that right, Borsham? Well, this is risque, but I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go to Borsham.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm just gonna move this to Rock Slide.
Oh, why did I move you?
I don't know.
I'm gonna move to Borsham. I'm going to pay a coin for visiting. And I'm going to spend 1 wood for a pirate and 1 wood and a coin for a serpent. And I can do this for as many times as I have active crew, and I have a lot of crew, so. And that's it. I'm going to do my free action is to deal with this event that is occurring. And I will read it. On your way to Borsham, you come upon a huge salt serpent attacking a small merchant ship. The crew members wave for help as monsters devours them one by one. Attack power of 3. This is going to be tough. So I got a 5, and that does it. So 5.
Okay.
4 attack. All right. So I use both of them. I go up 2 influence, and I gain 1, 2. I gain, actually, no. Sorry. 2 influence, and I gain renown. +1 when you place a cube on the track. I place 2 cubes.
Mm-hmm.
I go up 2 renown, right?
Nice.
That's it.
Okay.
And this goes to Zillium?
To Zillium.
All right.
Okay. My turn?
Yep.
All right. Excellent. 1, 2. I am going to treasure hunt Zillium.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Oops. Thank you. The only thing I'm going to do here is take that action. So I'm going to pay a coin.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to exhaust one of my administrators. And I'm going to get 2 cubes on the renown track.
You have to pay $1.
I just did.
All right. So did you read what's happening?
Yeah. Yeah, sure. A young healer sends word. We're searching for a cure for the deadly rose plague, but we need coin for the voyage. Oh. So I guess I'm using my administrator to kind of talk to them and then my coin to
very good.
So pay for the voyage.
I
so
need 2 cubes, please.
Thank you very much.
And you are now on the track. That's it for you?
That's it.
Move that to Farwald, please.
Here?
Yes. No. Move the brown.
Oh, the guy. Okay.
To Farwald.
Okay.
And I will. All right. 1, 2. I'm going to Rock Slide. And I'm going to pay 3, 4, 5 influence to take over Rock Slide.
Okay.
I get $5, please. And now I get to visit for free if I so choose. So I'm going to pay 2 gold to visit. I get a book. Shepherd book. Why do you give me $1?
You get a buck.
A book.
A book. Why is every time you say that?
I don't know. All right, so I get a book and 2 renown.
Okay.
I will... Oh, I wish I bought that building first. That stinks. All right. I'm not gonna. Well, maybe I'll buy this one. So for $4.
Okay.
I get a $1 discount. I'm gonna buy this. This library, so I get plus one renown when I get a book, which is why I wish I had it sooner. But I get a renown for building, so I'm on 6. And you're up.
Okay, can you refresh the house offer, please?
I cannot.
Thank you. Oh. All right, my turn. 1, 2. All right, so I'm going to exhaust my administrator, pay my coin. I'm going to build. I'm going to build the bank. Thank you. So the bank, when I visit a town, I pay entry costs from the supply, not from my own hand.
That's good.
So I'm going to go there. But let me pay for it real quick. So that's 3 wood and 2 of my fishies. And that is it. So it's a Europe.
All right, I'm going to go to Farwald. And I'm going to visit. And I'm going to toot my own horn. So I'm going to get this one, which is brag of your control. Plus 2 renown per seaboard where you control more towns than any player, not counting home ports. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 8 renown.
Okay.
So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I get 2 of these, actually. So I get 2 pirates and a serpent, please. Thank you. I'm done.
All right, and...
Oh, I get a fish or 2, or 2 fish or a wood. I'll take 2 fish, please.
2 fish?
Actually, no, I'll take the wood.
Okay.
Sorry. I've got plans.
Okay, I'm going to go to the grotto. I'm going to pay from the bank, so put that in the treasure map, please. I am going to get 1 renown, so if you give me one of those 7 chips, please.
Well, you get 4 wood
with
that.
That's going to give me 4 wood. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I get 3 fish plus 1 for every deckhand, which I have 2. So I get 3, 4, 5. But I can only take 4 because I am going to be over capacity. So theoretically, I could give up my wood or my fish or whatever, but the healthy mix. So 1, 2, 3, 4, fish. And you bought me up my renown, and I think that is it. So you're up.
All right. What to do? Probably should have taken those fish instead. I don't know what I was thinking. All right.
I'm trying to play quicker this game.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm not saying you should.
1, 2. I'm gonna go to Rat's. No, I don't really want to go to Rat's Nest. It's kind of a rat's nest. So maybe I'll go to...
You want more pirates?
No, I'll go to Fell's Garden.
Okay.
And I'll... Do I want to do that? Nah, I'm just going to treasure hunt.
Okay.
That's it.
All right. Oh, you took all the administrators, I guess. Well, there's only 1 so far. Our people are all deckhands up there.
I know,
there's
great.
There's nobody very good.
A lot of good workers out there.
Where?
Hands.
Oh, yeah. All right, I'm gonna go to... What do we have up here? Pay pirates, I don't have. Look at Farwald. 1, 2, 3. All right, I'm just gonna go here. And pay this to the treasure map. And I'm just going to sleep my people.
You get a fish or a wood.
I can't carry anything else.
Oh, you're full. I wonder what you're going to spend those on.
I know what you're going to spend those on. I'll take care of that right quick. Don't you worry.
I bet you will. If ever you know what I want.
Yes. I want to go here and take...
Over? No, oh, you can't.
I'm actually going to go to Rock Slide instead.
Okay.
Because it's free. And I'm going to pay 4 gold.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to pay... Oh, wait, I get books here?
Yes, you do.
I don't want to get books.
Where were you here?
Yeah.
All right.
I want to spend books. Where can I spend books?
Where can you spend books? Krimska.
Or in Thundrake, which is free. I can get renowned for that. Because I want to spend about 2 of my books.
Okay, we'll move to Thundrake then.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to go to
Krimska.
Yeah, of course.
Fantastic.
And I'll pay
$1, please.
I'll pay you $1. And the reason I'm doing that is because I'm going to spend 2 books, and I gain 2 influence tokens. But every time I place an influence token...
You get a renown.
Right.
Okay.
So it'd be kind of a waste to go down there.
Sounds good. Are you done with your turn?
I am.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I am going to Stratic.
Okay.
And I will pay you.
Uh-huh.
And I will exhaust my guy. Uh-huh. I like keeping my pirate up there. He's cool.
I know.
He's not really a pirate. He's more like a captain. Captain Jack Sparrow. And I'm going to build. And you know what I'm building.
I do.
I'm building the palace. So you get +1 renown per unused resource, basically, so fish or wood at the end of the game. Plus it's worth 13 points.
Ooh.
So I'm gonna build that. And it costs me all of my hard-earned resources.
Every last bit.
Every last one. All right, you are up.
Okay, so.
What are you going to do?
Where did I go? Up there and I spent my books. So I'm gonna go to the grotto, please, if you'll be so kind.
Mm-hmm.
And in the grotto, I'm gonna pay a gold, and I'm gonna take fish.
Okay.
3, 4, 5, 6 fish I get.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. And I get 1 renown. All right, your turn.
My turn?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Where do I want to go? Okay, I'm going to go here first. And I'm going to get another hand. Just give me that free one on the end.
All right, so exhaust
one. Eyeball.
And pay.
This weird eyeball.
And pay from the bank.
Yep, hold on. Hold your horses. I'll exhaust him. And I'll pay $1. And now I get 1 wood per hand, so I get 3 wood.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3. And that's it.
That's it?
Yeah, that's all.
Alright. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
So I'm going to toot my own horn.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to play Brag of Your Reach.
Mm.
And I'm going to get +2 renown per each town I control.
Okay.
So that would include my port town. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 10 renown.
That includes your port town?
Because, yeah, on other cards it says excluding port. So it specifically states.
Okay.
All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I guess so that's at least it'll be worth 2 regardless. So it's not worth 0.
Oh, like the ones at the beginning when I tried to get them?
Mm-hmm. So that's worth 10.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Get this. I get a serpent, please.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Almost fell.
Falls all right,
I get 2 fish, I'll take.
Okay.
And I'll pay a hand.
Mm-hmm.
And 4 fish.
Okay.
For the Far World event.
All right.
The Far World event is a wealthy merchant meets with you for dinner. Bandits have stolen all the supplies from my stone cutting operation and workers need food. Could you help us out? So I helped, gave them 4 food. I get 3 influence. And 3 renown for that. 1, 2, 3, because of my house. I get this, which gives me 2 more influence, but it's full, so I don't get anything. And that's it. So what happens when a pile runs out? We actually split this in half between the two. So Stratic and Rock Slide are the two. So that's gotta go to Stratic.
Stratic. Okay.
All right.
Perfect.
That's it.
All right, I'm going to go to Zillium.
Mm-hmm.
And at Zillium, I'm going to... hold on a second. Did you move my cube again when you got your final token?
I'm moving yellow.
Are you
sure?
You
went off the board because you took the...
I did?
Yeah, you're 4 wood. You landed on it.
Okay.
Yeah, all you've right. been off the board since then.
Okay. All right. Okay. I will, I'm going to take over Zillium.
All right. So which one's
so, I'm going to use... Those two at the top, the 2 threes.
The 2 high ones.
Yes. Actually, you know what? Put this one back. Yeah.
Probably
up
take
there.
Those
That's two. What I was thinking. Yeah. So I'm gonna do that, and we'll put one there. I get 2 renown for doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I get to visit.
You get 6 gold too.
Oh yeah, I do.
Definitely want that.
Yeah. Okay. I can pay a wood, right? Because I'm visiting now. So I'm going to pay a wood. I'm going to exhaust a worker. And that's going to get me a book.
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my visit. Oh, yeah. Thanks. And then now I'm going to build something with money. I'm going to build the barracks.
The barracks, so for 6 bucks, you're building the barracks.
So this gives me 4 renown when I conquer a player's port.
What are you trying to say?
What?
Stay away from my ports.
So, there we go. And that's it. I'm done.
Yeah, you and your love to take that mechanic.
I didn't take anything yet.
You're about to. That's no good. That's no friendly. I am going to go and I'm going to take over Farwold.
Okay.
So it's going to be taken with either influence or or attack. So I just need to pay 12.
Mm-hmm.
3, 6, all right, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Perfect.
Bang. So I get 12 gold.
Okay.
I took over Farwold. And now I get to visit.
So I am going to, I guess I'll do this. I get one renown for every ready sailor, and I got four. So I get four. One, two, three, four. And I get a fish, two fish. I'll take two fish, please.
Okay. There you go.
All right. And I'm going to buy a building. I'm going to pay 6 gold. Because I get a dollar discount. And I'm going to buy the market. And the market's going to give me +3 gold when I ally with the town, which I should have got before, was I thinking. But I get a renown for building a building. And I get 3 more gold. Please. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm done.
Okay. Okay. All right. I'm going to go one, two. I'm going to go to Stratic. But I'm not visiting. I'm treasure hunting.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to take the free action in Stratic. So I'm going to exhaust the deck hand. Mm-hmm. Well, let me read the text first. Can you hand that to me?
Oh, you're going
to
do the event.
Yep.
Okay.
So, in Stratic, a local musician approaches you at the docks. We're a bit short on supplies for the new dance hall. Could you spare some help? So, I'm going to pay a hand. And 2 wood, and I guess help them build a dance hall. Nice. But I'm going to get 3 influence.
Wow, so the hand of the king.
The hand of the king.
And 3 tokens, please.
Yep. So, Anthony's just going to put those on there left to right for me. And I'm going to pay my 2 wood.
All right.
And I think I'm going to pay 4.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to
pay for what?
No, I don't want to do that. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to pay 4, and I'm going to build the lodge.
Whoa.
There's your card.
I want Ichor.
You love that one, I know.
I'm buying it.
I know you are.
I have to.
Alright, we'll go then. Where's our next guy go? Grinnell?
Grinnell.
Grinnell.
Grinnell. Grinnell.
Where is it?
Right there.
Oh, there we go. The map changes every time,
I know. That's so you never know. Like, yeah. I'm so used to things being like that.
Different places.
The fall world being on this side. Alright, so I'm going to go to Moreland.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pay. Oh, wait. Yeah, it's the only one I can go to. Yeah, so I'll go to Moreland. I'll pay 7 influence, but I'm going to take it over.
Okay.
So it's worth 5 gold.
Mm-hmm.
+3 when I ally, so I get 8 gold.
Okay.
So I've got 8 gold. I'm going to visit, so I'll take a free deck hand. Why not? And 1 wood per hand, so I'll take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I get 3, 9. So I still have enough room here. 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm full. I get the full 10. I guess I'll buy a core.
Okay.
For 11.
Okay.
Get a dollar discount. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I get the. So now I gain Ichor the Serpent. Discard Ichor when used, and then gain him back when you gain at least 1 sea serpent. So he keeps coming back into my hand. Ichor, please.
Okay.
So I get Ichor in my fleet. I gain a renown when I build a building. Oh, sorry, that's you. Gain a renown.
I'm gonna check this tape.
Stop it. Oh, stop it. But that's it. That's the eighth building.
Okay. So we each get one more turn.
Right.
I think.
We do.
We do. Mm-hmm. Now, you're technically the last player.
Right, so...
So, we don't get to finish the round, per se. Like, if you were the first player, I would actually go.
Yep.
And then we would both go again.
Right.
But since I was the first player, you just went... Now, the next round is just the kind of cleanup
round. It's the final round, so...
Yep. It's the final countdown.
Final countdown.
Okay. I'm going to go here, and I'm taking over Rat's Nest.
What? Oh, okay. So she is taking over an owned.
Yeah, so I'm going to take over this that Anthony owns. So how this works is, I'm going to make sure I have enough, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, yes, I have enough. So when you take over a player-owned town in either attack or using diplomacy, you just add 2 to the total. Mm-hmm. Now, when I get the money for this, because I will get paid for taking over the town, you still take the number that's on the flag, but it's like it takes a little extra effort, I guess. So I'll need to pay 9 to take over Rat Nest. So that's that. And my little cube will go here, and you can have that back.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm taking Rat Nest. I get 2 renown when I ally with the town, which I did. And I get 4 when I when it's conconquering a player's port.
Port.
Ah,
so. Not a town.
That sucks. That's the only reason I did that. Oh, that sucks. Oh, well.
But you get 7 bucks, yeah, and that's not bucks. A bad thing.
That's not a bad thing.
Especially if you want to buy more buildings.
That stinks. That was my plan. If I want to buy more buildings, like right now. I get to get 2 pirates. I get to rest all my workers because I'm visiting for free now.
You took the Rat's Nest.
I did. And now I can take some free actions. So, I only have 2 books though. And none of these are really like end of game things. Ah, that sucks. All right. Well, I'm done. You can go.
You're not going to buy a house?
Doesn't matter.
I guess it doesn't matter. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Dollar for dollar. If you could send me to Krimska.
Okay. Oops. Okay.
I'm going to attack your home port.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, then I'm buying this card.
What?
Here, I gave you a redo.
Which one? Wait, what are you giving me, $1?
What? Oh, I pay that to the... Oh, I get that. Because it was only 4. All right. Go ahead.
I'm going to submit all of my guys.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dice. I need 12 combat. I'm gonna exhaust this guy for a 6th die.
The funny thing is, I was gonna buy that card, and yeah. I was like, "Nah, he's not gonna take anything over from me."
That was not a great roll, but I'll take that there. I guess that there. That. These don't matter. They're both junk. So that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I'm gonna have to injure. Crewman for the 12th.
Mm-hmm.
So bang, I take it. No, I need 14, right? Because it's yours. So I injured 2 more.
Okay. Just throw them all overboard.
I should. It doesn't matter.
You're the worst captain.
I really am.
Let me see your token.
It's a token of appreciation.
Oh, right.
I get 12 bucks. I get 3 renown when I attack a town and take a town from another player. 1, 2, 3. So I get 2 more pirates in return. But I killed Ikor, which, you know how that makes me feel.
I know.
When I lose Ikor.
You like using Ikor, though.
I do. That's what you get him to be used, right?
Yeah.
Because you get him back. Next time I buy a serpent, I get him back.
Yeah.
But since I took the port, now I get to visit.
Okay, can you give me my four or my three renown, please?
Oh, you get three renown?
Yeah.
Okay, so I get to visit. And I visit the bed and wake all my guys up. So these guys actually are still asleep, but they're all hurt. So that's the price of the price of using them in combat. So I think for my last action, I'll just buy. Oh, why bother? Right.
It doesn't really matter.
Because the thing is, coins are worth
it's one to one anyway.
Buildings. So. If I had a building that actually gave me bonuses for more buildings, then it would probably make sense to do that. But at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter. So, so that's it. I'm done. So okay. Is that the end?
Yep.
All right. So we're gonna gather our stuff here and start, and we'll show you how to score the game. Okay.
Right. Let's add it up.
So you basically take all of your buildings, all of your monies, and all of your renowned tokens that you've earned throughout the game. So let me get these out of the way so we don't confuse them. And that's really all that matters, right? So it's about points. And every point of renown is worth a dollar, and every dollar is worth a point of renown. Now, if you don't have any like special bonus scoring cards at the end, it really doesn't matter. So you stacking them in?
I stacked them in tens. All right. Makes it easy.
It does. It certainly does. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten, eight, nine. Oops, eight, nine, ten, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and then these. All right, so I've got 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times 7 is 49. So 70 plus 49 is what?
I only got 62, so
119 plus 5 is
124.
It's
good.
Wow. At least the highest I've ever scored.
This is the lowest I've ever scored, and that's the biggest disparity we've ever had.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
Want to recap?
Let's recap. All
right.
So, Islebound.
How did it feel to win?
What? It feels great.
Good.
Actually, it feels very good.
I'm glad we finally got to film this time.
Oh, really? Okay. So, that's the highest I've ever scored in this game.
Yeah.
We've played this multiple times.
Probably at least four or five times.
Four or five times. We played with three players a couple times, and then the two of us a few times. Mm-hmm. And I gotta say, it's usually very close. So
it is.
This was the biggest dispersion that we've seen of scores, and that might be the fact that it's a two-player game, right?
Perhaps.
Because you really have your open reign.
I guess because the other times that we've played, one of the biggest things that I've liked about this game is that there's so many different ways to win.
Right.
We played a three-player version of this over the weekend, mm-hmm. I think, or the other day, and. We all had very different strategies, and we all ended up very, very close.
Within a few points. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's how it's always been. So that was one of the things that I really liked about it.
Hmm.
Didn't work out this time.
No. Like for this playthrough, I definitely played a lot more aggressive than I normally do, just because I wanted to kind of speed the game. I didn't want to have two. I really did. There were moments of AP in there.
I saw Agent Peterson a few times.
Yeah, but I was getting a little. I got locked into my strategy. But in all honesty, like I don't normally buy buildings that quickly, and I was spending everything I had on buildings early.
Well, and you were taking treasure all the time.
And I was taking treasure all the time.
Money and you know.
Yeah, so I was taking treasure and buying buildings. I mean, but that strategy, buying buildings, mm-hmm. is what does it. A lot of those buildings have bonuses for when you buy other buildings and when mm-hmm. you do other things. If you wait till late in the game to start buying buildings, you're passing up all of those bonuses. So the trick, at least for what I saw, was get the buildings early and then reap the rewards throughout the game.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then taking over towns, like you see money scarce.
Mm-hmm.
Taking over towns is where you start really raking in the cash.
Well, and actually, this was the first game that you really used your influence.
I did.
Because that's usually my strategy.
Yes.
So, I think maybe you learned from me a little bit and started using your influence a little bit more.
I used it a lot this game.
Taking over towns.
It's a good strategy to block somebody who really is building like an influence strategy, because
you sit your markers on the influence track and just don't spend your influence, and they can't gain anymore.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, or you know, you spend yours, and now I have to start all the way at the beginning of the track.
Yes.
So, yeah, that works. So, well, that's usually what I think the first game we played. I won.
You were all influence. Yeah.
Crazy. But I was just all influence, and he's sitting here buying pirates, and you were buying pirates and serpents and having fun.
I thought it was
fun. Doing
that's
that
the
stuff,
way I wanted to. Yeah, I like to be the aggressor.
Yeah, know. And at the end of the game, he's like, "How'd you win?"
Yeah, and I got crushed. It seemed like I was doing good, but I got crushed.
Yeah.
But this time I like really spread across the board.
I could have done a little bit better, but I didn't have stuff in my cabin. I had the one bonus that allows me to get, you know, like extra points for having fish and resources and stuff in my cabin.
Fish and chips, yeah.
But you ended the game so quickly, I didn't have a chance. So
I did. Eight buildings. That's it. Now, like I said, if you do not buy buildings, you will not end the game.
Yeah.
Like, we could have played for another 2 hours if I didn't buy buildings. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And just kept collecting resources.
Yeah.
So, well, that's it. That's the that's Islebound. Mm-hmm. We picked this up at Gen Con.
Very good game, though.
And we play it.
Yeah,
we played it a lot. Probably the most out of all the games we've bought so far.
Yeah.
Just because it's a little bit lighter.
Mm-hmm.
It's deep in strategy, but it's very light to teach, and it's not intimidating. And and like all these games, that people just fall in love with the art right away.
Right.
It's just a beautiful game. Yeah, it's definitely a beautiful game. So.
Yeah. Oh, one thing we didn't mention is that the designer actually put on the opposite side of your crew members.
Oh, yes.
If you have Above and Below, or you acquire Above and Below, you can actually use your crew on the other side as explorers in Above and Below too.
Indeed.
So that's kind of cool. So I'm kind of excited to bring our little tokens into Above and Below.
At Gen Con, we also got the Hidden Fog single card expansion, which completely changes the way the game plays.
Yeah.
We haven't tried that yet.
Mm-hmm.
I just saw the rules the other day online on the website, and
I think we're playing it.
We're going to try it. Yeah, definitely. So will we make a video? Who knows? We'll see. We have so many other games in the queue ever since Gen Con. So, but that is Islebound. Hope you enjoyed the playthrough.
Mm-hmm.
We will see you next time. Please subscribe, and thanks for watching.
Good game.
All right.